hypothesis. If you analyze, a data was collected about all the people who lived above 100 years from 1932 to 1952. And on this data, a person by the name of O. Cigares, he wrote a book, Living to be 100, 1,200 people who did and why they did it. Everything is mentioned. In it, even diet is mentioned. Do you know out of 1,200 people, how many were vegetarian? How many? Guess. 1,000. Four. Four. This survey wasn't done to prove veg food or non-veg food. It was done for other reasons. But even the diet was mentioned. It's a fact. It's not a research. It's a fact. Out of 1,200 people who lived in the span of 20 years, over 100 years, only four were vegetarian. You know alcohol? Alcohol alone. It is a veg diet or not? Alcohol is veg or non-veg? Veg. From juices or fruits. And the disease that are caused by alcohol alone is more than all the non-veg disease put together. One vegetable diet. So just for alcohol, I cannot say that all vegetable foods should be banned. Today, scientists, and we'll agree, it's mentioned in these books also, the cause of maximum death in the world today is alcohol, number one. So I don't ban all veg food. What do I say? As Quran says, Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 90. Ya yuladin amanu, innama al-khamru al-maisuru, wa anzabu al-aslamu, rishtum minam al-shaytan, fashtanibu lalakum taflihun. That, oh, you believe? Verily, intoxicants and gambling and idol worship and dedication of stones and divination of arrows, these are Satan's handiwork. Abstain from it that you may prosper. Alcohol is a Satan's handiwork. Abstain from it. I only prohibit alcohol, not all veg food. And smoking. Second greatest cause of death in the world. Veg or non-veg? Veg. Can you prevent the alcoholic disease? Only way you can prevent is defermented. It ceases to be alcohol. Can you prevent smoking disease? Don't have tobacco. Only option is prohibition. If there is no prevention, then comes the question of prohibition. So alcohol is prohibited. There are more than 400 fatwas by Islamic scholars. Smoking is prohibited because there is no prevention. You know Kesari Dal? Kesari Dal? Indian government has banned it. It causes spastic paraplegia. Staple food of Northwest Indians. Banned. Why? It causes death also. Spastic paraplegia. Alcohol. Many countries have banned, including Saudi Arabia, including states in India have banned it. Smoking in Singapore is banned in public places, in government places, in public transport. Cases are banned by India. If there's no prevention, then you can ban it. I do not know of a single government that has banned all non-veg food in general. Not a single. Yes, few non-veg food, like pork, Saudi Arabia has banned. There's no prevention, ban it. If there's no prevention, then you prohibit it. And the debate was not which is better, which is healthier, veg or non-veg. The debate was, is non-veg food permitted or prohibited? I gave a list of more than 20 points. So I can very well say that Mr. Rashmi Vaidaveri conveniently stopped this talk 5 minutes before, not to answer these things. If you give me 1 hour more, I will continue speaking. Wild berries. They're poisonous. Strychnine, vegetable food. They're poisonous. Datura, poisonous. What's the solution? Don't have it. You know, water. Water has so many diseases transmitted. Cholera, paratyphoid, typhoid. It causes amoebiasis, giardiasis, roundworm, pinworm, vile hepatitis. I can go on talking. Only by water. What do you do? Do you ban water? You prevent it, you purify the water, the disease will be prevented. You know milk? Milk has so many diseases. Shigella, cholera, paratyphoid, typhoid, tuberculosis, salmonellosis, brucellosis. I can go on listing. What do? Do you ban milk? What do? You pasteurize it. You don't ban it. You don't prohibit it. It's unmedical. Whether milk is non-veg or veg is a debatable topic. I won't argue on that. So, if you cannot prevent the disease, then do you prohibit it? I have given various reasons, which Mr. Rashmi Vaidaveri hasn't replied. There's not a single government who has banned non-veg food in general. There's not a single major religion which has banned non-veg food in general. Therefore, I say that that non-veg food is permitted, not prohibited. If I have heard the feelings of any vegetarians while giving the replies to the speaker, I sincerely apologize from the bottom of my heart. I would like to end the talk by giving the quotation of the glorious Quran from Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 81, which says, وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلُ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ زَهُوقًا. When truth is heard against falsehood, falsehood perishes. For falsehood is by its nature bound to perish. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.
Now we begin the open question and answer session. To extract maximum benefit in the limited time that we have available in the question and answer session, we expect the following rules to be observed. Your question should be on the topic only, that is non-vegetarian food permitted or prohibited for a human being? Questions out of the topic will not be permitted. Kindly state your question briefly and to the point. This is not a lecture time, neither a cross-question time for the questioners. I repeat, kindly state your question briefly and to the point. This is not a lecture time, neither a counter-question time for the questioners. Mr. Zaveri and Dr. Zakir should answer comprehensively, and each answer should not exceed 5 minutes. 4 mics have been provided in the auditorium, 2 next to the stage for the gents, and 2 in the rear central aisle for the ladies. If you wish to put a question to Mr. Zaveri, kindly queue up behind the mic with the name clip, question for Mr. Zaveri, similarly so in the ladies. And if you wish to put a question to Dr. Zakir, kindly queue up behind the mic with the name clip, question for Dr. Zakir. Only one question at a time may be asked. For your second question, you would have to go right at the back of the queue again and await your second chance. Written questions on slip papers, which are available from the volunteers in the aisles, would be given secondary preference if time permits. On your slip where you are putting a question, kindly tick or write to whom your question is addressed, Mr. Zaveri or Dr. Zakir, or it might be put aside. Kindly state your name and profession before putting forward your question so that the speakers would be in a better position to answer you. We would allow one question on each of the mics in a clockwise rotation, alternately addressed to each speaker. May we have the first question from the mic on my left? So we have first gents, ladies too, then gents again. Yes, brother, we can have the first question from you.